What's up, guys? In this video, you are going to learn how to back up your iPhone to iCloud. All right, guys, iCloud still remains like this like mystery among Apple users. I feel like people still don't really understand it or know how to use it. I've got some other videos on my channel that you should definitely check out to kind of get an understanding of iCloud. And I have an ultimate iCloud guide that I literally wrote like tons of pages of step-by-step tutorials to teach you everything about iCloud, and it's free. It is the best free guide book that you can find on the internet, in my opinion, to teach you how to use iCloud. So make sure you download that if you need a little bit of iCloud help. But let's talk about how to back up your iPhone to iCloud. Now, I'm going to talk about some big misunderstandings right off the bat so that you kind of understand why you're not able to back up your iPhone to iCloud. So I'm gonna go in right here to the settings on my iPhone to show you guys what I'm talking about. So right here in iPhone settings, if I click on my Apple ID account, I can go to iCloud. Now, you'll notice I don't pay for iCloud storage. So you'll see right here at the top of my screen, I have 5 gigabytes of free iCloud storage. Every Apple user gets 5 free gigabytes. You'll notice my iCloud storage is nice and clean because I have my settings appropriately assigned for that. And like I said, I've got other videos that will teach you how to do that. But if you want to do iCloud backups, you're going to go down here to iCloud backup and turn that on. At that point, your iPhone will automatically back up to iCloud. So you really don't have to do anything else at this point. And you'll just know that like your iPhone will just really always be backed up to iCloud. I don't have iCloud backup turned on because I don't pay for iCloud storage. If you pay for iCloud storage, meaning you pay and have like 100 gigs or a terabyte or whatever, 200 gigs of iCloud storage available, then you can turn this on. If you have the free amount of iCloud storage, this better be turned off. And I'm gonna show you why in just a second. But yeah, that is technically how to back up your iPhone to iCloud. You just go right there, turn that on, and it's gonna be backed up. But if you don't have enough storage, it is going to fail. And here is why. I'm gonna grab my laptop really quick so I can show you why your iCloud storage backup fails. So if I go right here into iTunes, I just really be wherever. I'm gonna go to the top of the screen right here, and I'm going to click iTunes button and click preferences. Now, it's probably gonna go to general, but if you click all the way over here to devices, you're going to see the devices that you have backed up to iTunes. Now, this video isn't to show you how to back up to iTunes. I got another video on that that you can find. But this is just to show you why your iCloud backup is not working. So if I click on any of these, I'm going to right click or two finger click, I guess, on the touchpad and click show in Finder. Now you got a funky folder with lots of numbers. I can right click again and click get info. Now you're gonna see right there that this whole folder is full of 32.1 gigabytes of data. A typical iPhone backup takes 30 gigabytes or more of storage space. So if you think back to your iCloud storage, you only have 5 gigabytes. Well, a backup requires 30. So that's why you're not able to back up your iPhone to iCloud unless you pay for extra storage. So what I recommend people do who don't pay for iCloud storage is to back up their iPhone to iTunes. And you're just gonna wanna plug it into your iTunes and do that like every couple months, I guess, to be safe. And I've got another video to show you how to do that. But that's the best way to do it if you don't pay for storage. If you do pay for storage, by all means, feel free to use iCloud backup. All right, guys, if you like this video, if you learned something new, hit the thumbs up button for me and leave me a comment. I love to hear from you guys. I like to read all the comments and respond to pretty much all of them. So introduce yourself, let me know what questions you have about anything technology related, and I'll do my best to do a video for you. All right, guys, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to check out some of these other videos we've got here on our channel. Just click the thumbnail, it'll take you right to it.